Oceans and seas have a variety of names, but one of the seas named Red Sea has a magnificent reason behind it. Is the sea red? Well, kind of yes. The Red Sea is a tropical sea that has coral reefs in a huge amount. No rivers connect the sea, and it is an extremely salty sea with an average 40% salinity. That means around 40 grams of salt in 1 kg of water. The Red Sea contains a cyanobacteria named Trichodesmium erythrium. These bacteria do photosynthesis and can turn the Red Sea from a bluish color to a red color. They are also called as sea sawdust because they form a reddish color and are present in abundance in the Red Sea. We can see this bacterium through the naked eye because they live in colonies or in individual filaments where hundreds of cells are bound together. The pigment that makes these bacteria turn red is unknown and still under research. The pigment may be phycobilin pigments with phycoerythrin and phycocyanin for red and blue pigments respectively. These pigments may be the cause of red color of Trichodesmium erythrium. To sum it up, the Red Sea contains a bacterium named Trichodesmium erythrium, which gives it a reddish color. They are photoautotrophic, that means they depend on photosynthesis to make their food. They live either in filaments or clusters of cells. Same way, the Black Sea has a depth of over 150 meters and its deepest layers is only sulfur bacteria, which produce the hydrogen sulfide gas. It decomposes the dead organic matter of the sea and gives it a composted blackish color. The White Sea is said to be white because it is covered in ice for 6 to 7 months each year. The Yellow Sea is named yellow because it carries silt from the upper plains, which gives it a brownish yellow color. So remember why the Red Sea is called red and what bacteria grows in it. We hope you enjoyed this. Scientium, we'll be back. No stop learning. Thanks.